commissioner who is here, Linda Shaw, many, many years ago, another young lawyer and I worked for her husband in Guilford County as assistant county attorneys. And that young lawyer and I, during each month, we'd get paid one time a month, and toward the end of the month, we would start running out of money and looking for places to get something to eat. And we would go out to the county farm you're talking about there, own business, of course, and be invited to lunch quite often. That young fellow was a guy by the name of Howard Coble.
How about that?
And Howard, I brought that up at a meeting one time, and Howard was there, and he said, "I think I probably went out there more than David knew." I think as far as the presentation, that Alamance County will continue to keep an open mind, and we will look at the progress that those who are planning this matter, the progress that they make. I am not ready to commit either way. I don't know about the rest of the commissioners. If you want to comment, please go right ahead. And the next item, the spotlight on veteran services, we're going to carry that over to the next meeting, which will be in 2 weeks. Tom, you got finance officer's report?
Thank you, Chairman. I do. Just a brief update on a couple of things I'd like to comment on. Good morning, Mr. Chairman, fellow commissioners. From a former commissioner, I appreciate the presentation. Appreciate the opportunity to serve all of you and the citizens of Alamance County in my new role. I want to comment briefly on where we are financially. One of the concerns that we all had was timeliness of financial information, kind of where we are, where we're going, particularly in light of entering our budget season, which basically started a couple of weeks ago. Susan Roberts was instrumental in getting the budget request forms out to the different departments within the county, and they've already been sent out. They're scheduled to be out in a couple of weeks. So I wanted to take just a minute. We received a report from Crystal Roberts of Martin Starnes, our external accounting firm, back in November prior to the submission of the actual year-end audit. And she basically highlighted some things. We then were given a copy of the audit, but there really wasn't any comment on it. So what I wanted to do was just summarize what we've already seen. For June 30th, 2013, you can see we had total revenue of $123 million, and by far, the majority of our revenue comes from our property taxes. We also get a significant amount in local sales tax, almost $21 million. The restricted intergovernmental, basically, are the pass-through grants that go to the different agencies that we serve, and then everything else. Total revenue of $123 million. Our total expenditures, nearly $122 million. By far, the largest segment of the county funds are allocated toward public education. Second, with as far as local funds, goes to public safety. And then third, mm-hmm. human services, that does include the grant money there, primarily for Department of Social Services and Department of Health. So we had revenue of 123, expenses of 122 million, leaving revenue excess of about $1.7 million. We were able to take some other financing sources, primarily a portion of the lottery proceeds, which we're entitled to use to pay interest on our public school bonds. That helped tremendously last year in increasing our fund balance by about $4.5 million. So our fund balance started the year before at $21.6 million, ended at $26.3 million. We were kind of joking with Crystal when she was here about whether or not we were going to receive a letter. Are we going to get another letter, or are we out of the woods? There are some minor adjustments between the fund balance and the available fund balance, primarily what takes out their restricted grants, the things that we can't really touch. So if you look there, the year in 2013, our available fund balance adjusted is about $20 million. Compared to our expenditures, you can see that took us from available fund balance percentage of 11.34% during the prior year to currently 16.57%. So I'm pleased with that improvement. It does not necessarily mean we're out of the woods with respect to the local government commission, but we're certainly in a whole lot better position than we were. And I say that because the real reason we got a letter last year, if you look at the 11.34% on the available fund balance percentage, it was actually the lowest percentage of available fund balance in the state. That's why we got a letter. We certainly were above the required amount of 8%. 8% basically represents 1 month's worth of expenditures. And for the year ending 2012, we were the lowest one, which is why we got the letter. The comparisons that we'll see for 2013 will come out in March or April. We don't have that number now, but because we're now up to 16.57%, I feel like we're more out of the woods than certainly we were. The Local Government Commission further recommends that each county should strive to achieve the average of the state. And I'm not certainly advocating that, but to give you a general rule, the average is 24.73%. We're now at 16%. Dollar amount, what that translates to, is going from about $20 million in available fund balance to about $30 million, or an increase of $10 million. I don't think we need to do that. I think it doesn't hurt for us, though, to gradually keep it ratcheted up a little bit every year. So I think if we get a letter from the Local Government Commission, we can certainly justify the progress that we've made. Last thing I want to show you, we're talking about the economic development opportunities. I always get, I always have to chuckle a little bit. The last report of Alamance County local unemployment showed a tremendous improvement in our unemployment statistics. You can see on the right-hand side, from November 2012 to November 2013, that's the latest month we have, we'll get December shortly, our unemployment rate declined from 9% to 6.7%, which sounds really, really good. That's a decrease of about 25%. But what the papers don't tend to elaborate on is what's behind those numbers. And if you look at the labor force from 2012 to 2013, it actually declined. It declined fairly significantly, 74,000 down to 72,000. And our number of employed, and this is the real number I think we need to focus on, the number of employed in Alamance County grew on a year-to-year basis, a net 14. 14 jobs have been added to our labor force, even though our unemployment rate has declined from 9% to 6.7%. So what's happening is our labor force is declining. What that means is people are people are not looking for jobs. They've either moved away, they've given up, or in the case of what happened this past summer, we had a cut at the state level in terms of unemployment benefits. So less people were able to be qualified, and in essence, again, they gave up. So us having an unemployment rate of 6.7% down from 9%, to me, doesn't really give any of the numbers justice. And then, if we can, Ron, show the numbers through December 31. I want to comment on a couple of these. This is 6 months. In theory, this is half of our year. How are we doing? Well, we're doing pretty well. Is there any way we can make that larger? Like the top half? There we go. Okay. So through 6 months, property tax, again, I said that was the highest source of our revenue. You can see there we're at 69% of collection. That doesn't mean a whole lot because of when the different property taxes come in. We actually get a huge segment by December 31st because of the year-end deadline on real estate. We also have the sales tax amount there. You see the $7.2 million. That does not include 2 months, because the sales tax data is delayed 2 months from the state. Susan found the numbers that we have up there are through 4 months, and when you extrapolate that to include what sales tax should be for the last two, we're right about 50%. I looked at last year's sales tax numbers for November and December and basically said, okay, if those are the same, where are they going to be? And the sales tax number for November, I think, was around $1.5 million. And Susan got the number for November, and it came out to be like $1.8 million or something. It's It's about $150,000 better. So we're that far to the good. So I'm optimistic about that. The other one I want to point out there is the sales and services number. That's money we get, revenue from some of the things that we do. A big one in there is money for the jail revenue. And that looks like it's down considerably. I talked to the sheriff about that, and there were 2 months, again, that were not reflected in that, that came in the first 2 weeks of January. So that helped that up. We're still going to be several hundred thousand dollars behind in that category, and the sheriff told me he made a call to the marshal's office inviting more guests to stay with us during the second half of the year. So we'll see what happens with that. So overall, if you look at the revenue sources, we're pretty much on target. Clyde's done a really good job of increasing our property tax collection percentage. We also have, if you see other taxes and licenses, that's going to be a good number for us now. That reflects the fact that the Department of Motor Vehicles is now collecting vehicle taxes at the time we renew. So you'll see that number go. That number at the end of the year may be combined with the total property taxes. But the fact is the collection rates are going to be a lot stronger because if people don't pay their property taxes, they're not going to be able to get their vehicle, the new sticker on their vehicle. So, Ron, if you can move up a little bit to the expense section. The only thing I want to point out here, expenses are on target. Basically, you see 47% and 50% of the year is over. This amount right here, contingency, this is the amount that as we see certain things, like the sheriff's request and Clyde's request for legal expenses, that will come out of this category. So it's not like we're going to go under budget or behind by utilizing these funds. What it does mean is we're using our cushion up, but you can see through 6 months, our cushion is still there, pretty solid, $875,000. So we had projected initially to be under by a little less than $1 million. I think with the amount we have in contingency and some other things that we have, we should be pretty close. So what that means is as we enter the budget season, I think we can assume that where we are at mid-year is a pretty good measure of where we'll be at the end of the year. One of the things that Susan and I will be looking at is when the department requests come back, we'll see their actual individual expenses through the 6 months, so we'll have a better feel for that. And then I'll just leave that and say, with respect to the budget process, Chairman Smith had suggested forming a budget committee. That's something that you may want to talk about. Certainly Susan and I are ready to participate in that process. I did review the audit and looking at what the auditors have done. We have been with this auditing firm for 3 years. Normally, I think it's healthy for a municipal entity to stay with one source 5 to 7 years before we start looking around again. That's my personal recommendation. They've done a good job for us. We could send out a request for proposal. They have already committed to us that they will do it for one more year at the same price they did it last year. I'm inclined to make that recommendation. So, any questions?
I've got a loaded one for you. And you were here when you questioned it. Now you're on the other side, and I hope you've seen the numbers.
I'm listening.
I'm trying to get it phrased. I'm under the influence. medicine. We're one month over half of the fiscal year and getting ready to go into budget. And I think all of us up here, especially Bill, question why we came in, and I'm glad we did, why we came in so much more to the good than we had explicitly asked questions about at the end of the fiscal year. In other words, we came in 4 million plus. And you've referred to year end. Why do you think we were off that much money, which almost promoted a vote for a tax increase or a bigger tax increase maybe than would have been approved? Why were we that much off as far as what you've seen?
Why were we that much off to the good?
Right, exactly.
And I think the number, Tim, is right there. Other financing sources, the $2.9 million. What we learned last year was through the formula that the county has with the lottery funds, we can use lottery proceeds to service debt on school bonds. And that's what we did last year. We utilized, you can see there, nearly $3 million. We were hoping and planning to have a $2 million or so increase in the fund balance from revenue over expenses. And that's what was going to happen. We got the additional plug there, the $3 million through that. We probably will have that again this year, but it's very, very difficult to estimate that at this time. Susan and I talked about that. What we said by the end of the third quarter, we might be in a better position to do that. But that's why. That's
but exactly did we why. Not know, and I'm not, you weren't there, but did we not know that was possible or probable?
We had that discussion. Do you want to comment? I don't want to put Susan on the spot. But
I can. We look at the sales tax revenue at the end of the year to see how it has compared to the debt service payments that we've made for the school system. In past years, the county did not utilize those funds, so it did take portions of our fund balance. In last year's evaluation, we were able to utilize those funds, so instead of taking money from our fund balance to support the payment of those debt service, we utilized state lottery funds so that we didn't have to dip further into our fund balance.
And we did look at the amount that we have allocated from the lottery right now. The school system does not have any major projects on tap to utilize that money. We get on a quarterly basis $300,000, it's about $1.2 million a year that's allocated from the lottery to our account for building projects for schools. But part of that provision is that money can be used to service the debt for existing school bonds.
Going into the last quarter, especially the last 2 months, do we believe that we'll be within $1 million of knowing exactly how we're going to wind up?
Well, we certainly hope so. And again, if you can go back to the 6 months to date, can you make that a little bit larger, Ron? Yeah, that's good. Revenues are projected to be under expenditures by $950,000, say $1 million. Our contingency is expected to be over by $750,000. All right, that difference there is a decline of $250,000. Our sales tax is up. It's up $150,000 a month so far, November, December. And by the way, our sales tax collections are not seasonal. I thought they were. I thought November, December would be big months. And I annualized what happened last year. The first 6 months are 51% of the total. So it's really not much seasonality at all. We'll have a pretty good handle on that. We should know, project where the jail revenues are going to come from. That's a big piece. And we already know what the property tax values, property tax revenue is going to be. So yeah, I think we can avoid the surprise, good or bad, as we enter the last month of the last quarter.
Good. We're good.
Anything else?
Bill wrote that question like a rodeo rider on a horse.
That's right.
Thank you, Tom. I wrote it too. I couldn't understand.
Well, yeah, everybody did, I think. And I never got a good answer till now.
All right, budget amendments, legal department.
Good morning. The first budget amendment is an amendment to recognize grant funds received from North Carolina Department of Agriculture for the developmental land rights. You may remember that the board in 2006 passed a resolution to preserve farmland in the county, and it is funded in part by state money and federal money and county funds. The county funds come from the collection of taxes when farm property is sold for other than farm use, and the taxes are paid back in. And in this particular transaction, we closed on 121 acres, the Wilkins Farm, and the state put in $124,900, and we'd like to take that money, and then it's already been spent to buy the easement.
Any questions? Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. The second item is number 66. It's request to transfer $75,000 from the county contingency fund to account 4150191, which is the DOJ defense account. We have now completed 54 depositions to date. In this case, we have two more remaining, one of which is the federal government's witness, Rose Salas. She did not appear at her deposition, so we were compelled to go to the federal court and ask for a motion to compel her to appear, which we have done that. And the last deposition is one of Sheriff Barnes. The DOJ took 8 depositions in the last month of the surrounding sheriffs, surrounding 5 counties. And we have completed our expert depositions in Philadelphia with Lambert and McDonald on the 27th and 28th of January, and completed our deposition of their expert Frazier in Austin, Texas on January 1st. And our expert was deposed in Greensboro on January 24th. I believe, unless they have some other witnesses that they haven't disclosed to us, that this will conclude the discovery stage of this litigation. And the money requested will pay for these depositions. We will have another stage beginning shortly, which is the portion of the case where we will make our motion for a summary judgment. We'll have to brief that. Ben Pierce and I have been working, preparing the preliminary work for that brief. Our attempt is to reduce the cost as much as possible. So we have been doing this in-house along with some of the sheriff's personnel to save costs. But it has been a very difficult 8 months of discovery, and I think we're at the end of it now. And I feel good about the testimony that we've received to date. You have to try and answer any questions.
Is there a motion on Budget Amendment 66?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pat. Government Social Services.
Yes, sir. So this is a budget amendment that we do a couple of times a year to kind of align all the changes in the General Assembly. We've gotten our last amendment in our daycare services for our reappropriation. So this just kind of shores everything up and aligns everything with all the General Assembly allocations that took place in the fall. Be glad to answer any questions.
Any motion?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Let me just update you. We have less than 30 cases on that food stamp awaiting list that you read about in the paper last week. We're in really good shape.
Great.
So
Thank you.
We'll meet the deadline.
County manager?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
One more.
One more. Part of our revenue funding is from state aid, and this year they never know exactly how much amount that's going to be. This year there were federal and state cuts to state aid, so there was less to spread out among the libraries, and ours was cut by $2,066, so we had to have a budget amendment cutting our budget by $2,066, and we're going to take that out of our communications line.
Any questions? Motion?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Now, County Manager.
Really have nothing to report at this time. I do know the chairman is going to mention a budget committee, and if once you mention that, I'll be glad to talk from there.
Commissioner's comments.
I'd like to bring up I think everybody's aware, and I think, in my opinion, my attitude is go on and do the cutting and trimming that we need to do. Do we not have 5 people that's going to be recommended for human relations next meeting?
We have sent letters out. There were some reappointments that were up that ran past their term. In conversations with the chairman, we've sent them letters and said that they would not be reappointed. So that will reduce that amount. I think there's been some discussion about looking at a separation between the human relations and the county. We were working on a resolution that hopefully we'll have at our next meeting that would look at that separation, if that is, for lack of a better word, if the board so chose.
Okay. See, my only concern was, I didn't know you were doing it.
I'm sorry.
Well, I never find out anything until somebody else calls me. Joke, that's a joke. It looks like I would have known.
We start Friday.
You know, my situation is I didn't want to fool with voting on these people or debating these people if that's what we were going to be doing. So they're not going to be on our agenda to approve or disapprove, right?
No, sir. Well, okay. The discussion was is having a resolution basically disavowing the county's responsibility from that committee, if that's the right word for you to consider.
Disaffiliation.
No.
You know, I called about that about a week ago.
Yeah.
But no offense, I mean, I don't know when I would have found out. But I'll support that, I'll tell you that when it comes up. Okay, I'm through.
Yeah, I've been talking to some people about the issue too, Steve and Mike, and I think you know that Steve has resigned, and Mike did some time before that. I would hope that the manager will work with those two gentlemen who know what's really going on and present to this board recommendations whether to, what's the word,
disaffiliate
or change it in some way that makes it functional, because it does not function at this present time.
It's not functioning in an apolitical manner.
Right.
I mean, I don't know, but one thing that I understand that they've instituted and... frankly, I would have opposed that, you know, so, and Mr. Kelly's been heavily involved, and I mean, in fact, hadn't been for his emails that I've received and pieces of information, I wouldn't have known what I know today, but it's, you know.
Steve, are you and Mike willing to work with the manager to make some recommendations to the board?
Absolutely, and if you'd like to give me just a minute, I'd like to make a statement that will help you with your decision.
But we're going to let you do it. We want it presented.
Whatever. Next meeting.
At the next meeting.
That would be great. Okay. I'll be here.
Thank you very much. Any other comments from commissioners? As I think I've mentioned it to all of you, I would like to propose a budget committee to give the commissioners a more of a working relationship with the budget. And I'm proposing that committee have five members. I believe the manager, the finance officer, finance manager Susan, and two county commissioners on that committee. And I've asked Commissioner Sutton and myself to serve on that. Is there any comments, or does the board want to think about it and go over it again? But that's what I would certainly propose.
Sounds good to me.
I'll actually go to a meeting.
Yeah, well, I guess we have a consensus, and that committee will be formed, Mr. Manager.
Yes, sir.
You as budget officer, if you would go ahead and set up the first meeting before our next regular scheduled commissioners meeting.
Yes, sir. As Tom mentioned earlier, the budget sheets have been given out. They're due back to his office February 14th. And so we'll probably look at setting up a meeting next week or so, if that's good.
Let's do it before the next meeting.
Yes, sir.
The first meeting.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other comments from commissioners? If not, do I hear a motion? Shoot.
My birthday is Thursday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. I don't want anybody to miss that opportunity.
You going to tell us how old you are?
Ronald Reagan and myself, we had the same birthday, February the 6th. I'll be 64.
I didn't think you'd tell us, but that's...
Well, I'm not ashamed of it. Most parts still work.
You're the youngest one on this board.
That's true.
Still here. Is there a motion to adjourn?
Same motion.
All in favor.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.